Hi everyone, a very good morning to all of you. I am Gulab Sa, your mentor, and I welcome you once again to another session of RBI 247, whereby on a regular basis, we try to discuss certain current financial happenings around us. So what we have for today? So today we are going to talk about the monetary policy statement that has been recently released by RBI. Now, we all have read and also seen a lot of videos on monetary policy statement that comes every bi-monthly, right? So bi-monthly, these monetary policy statements are released. So what are the changes that has been brought in this very season, that is in the month of September? What are the changes that has been brought in this monetary policy statement? We are going to look into this in this very video. So why to delay? Let's get started. But before that, if you have still not downloaded our app, you can do so by going on to the Google Play Store. So any kind of exam related updates, live video sessions, past year papers, as well as strategies, everything is available on this app. So make use of this app in order to further leverage your performance. So let's get started. So today, as I have mentioned, we are going to talk about the monetary policy statement for the month September 2022. But before starting that, let's talk about monetary policy. Monetary policy hota kya hai? So these are the tools and techniques that are used by the central bank of any country in order to maintain the liquidity in the market, as well as the money supply and the stability of the prices. Inflation na ho because of the money supply. So what is the objective of monetary policy? So it is very clear, as mentioned on the website of RBI, it states that the primary objective of monetary policy is to maintain the stability of the price while keeping in mind the objective of growth. So ऐसा नहीं बोला जाता कि हमें price बिल्कुल low रखना है. अगर आप prices को बहुत low रखोगे, then there will not be any kind of growth in the economy. अगर prices बहुत कम है, the whole demand will be low and everything will be low in that economy, right? So what is the objective? The objective is to rather make a balance. We need to balance between maintaining the prices of the goods and services in the economy, as well as trying to have more of growth in the economy. So what is the primary objective of monetary policy? Maintaining price stability, as well as keeping in mind the objective of growth. So this is the major or the prime objective of monetary policy. And in order to achieve this objective, the Monetary Policy Committee was established. Now, talking about the amendments that was made in the year 2016 in the RBI Act. So RBI Act mein amendment laya gaya tha in order to give these objective and the committee, the Monetary Policy Committee, a statutory basis. Statutory basis ka kya matlab hota hai? They have a legal sanction. So through this section in the article in the Act, they have been given a statutory basis, a statutory sanction for the implementation of the flexible inflation targeting framework. So in order to have a flexible inflation targeting framework, an amendment was made in the year 2016 to the RBI Act of 1934. So two major amendments. First is section 45ZA. Now these sections are important. Aapko yaad hona chahiye ki 45ZA mein kya bola gaya hai and 45ZB mein kya bola gaya hai. So these two sections are very important from your exam point of view. So let us understand section 45ZA mein bola kya gaya hai. So section 45ZA of the RBI Act says that the central government, CG stands for central government, in consultation with RBI, the central bank of the country, akele khud nahi karega, in consultation with RBI, needs to determine the inflation target, which will be based on the consumer price index. CPI based aapko ek inflation target decide karna hai, that too once in 5 years. To abhi ka inflation target kya hai? You all must be knowing. Jisko nahi pata, for them it is 4% plus or minus 2%. So this is the rate, this is the target, the flexible inflation target that has been determined by the central government and the Reserve Bank of India to be achieved during the course of the 5 years. Theek hai? Isko hame maintain rakhna hai so that there is price stability as well as growth in the economy. So these rates are changed after every 5 years. So will this be very stable? चेंज भी हो सकता है, नहीं हो सकता है, बट एवरी 5 years दिस विल बी टेकन इनटू कंसिडरेशन इन ऑर्डर टू ईदर हैव दिस फर्दर और टू चेंज दिस रेट. एंड वंस द रेट एंड द इन्फ्लेशन टारगेट इज डिसाइडेड, द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विल नोटिफाई दिस इन द ऑफिशियल गैजेट. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. व्हाट डज दिस the second section says, the second section talks about the constitution of a monetary policy committee. It says that a monetary policy committee should be constituted in such a manner that there are 6 members in the committee, and the main work or the primary objective of this committee is to determine the policy rate that is required to achieve this inflation target. तो पहले आरबीआई ही डिसाइड करता था, पर अब एक कॉम्प्रहेंसिव बॉडी बनाई गई है, दैट इज द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमिटी, दैट इज गोइंग टू लुक इनटू एंड ट्राई टू डिटरमाइन द पॉलिसी रेट, दैट इज द रेपो रेट दैट वी हैव इन आवर हैंड इन ऑर्डर टू अचीव द इन्फ्लेशन टारगेट दैट वी हैव सेट. आई होप दिस इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट the monetary policy statement for the month of September that has been released. So, देखो ये हर महीने हर every second month ये data release होती है, आपने read किया होगा, but these are very important. Why it is important? Questions can be asked directly from here, be it in your descriptive answer or even in the objective part as well. तो जब भी exam के आसपास हो, you need to remember these. इसके अलावा एक monetary policy report आती है, but that is released हाफ ईयरली, उसके बारे में कभी और बात करेंगे. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट वाज देयर इन द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी स्टेटमेंट फॉर द मंथ सितंबर 2022. फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट मीटिंग कब हेल्ड हुई थी, द मीटिंग वाज हेल्ड बिटवीन सितंबर 28 to 30th 2022. तो 30th सितंबर को ही रिलीज किया था मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी स्टेटमेंट. नाउ सर्टेन प्रोजेक्शन, सो दिस मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमिटी decides and talks about certain projections of what it feels will be the rate of growth in the economy and the inflation rate in the economy. So if we talk about the gross domestic product, the growth of the economy, they have projected it at a lower rate this time. Earlier they projected it at 7.2%, but now they have revised its projection to 7%. It means in the coming year, GDP is going, our economy is going to grow at an annual rate of 7%. Talking about CPI, they have maintained the previous estimate at 6.7%. So, jo previous estimate tha, wahi abhi bhi hai, that for the coming year, the CPI based inflation for India would be 6.7%. Talking about forex. अब फॉरेक्स रिजर्व्स का डेटा दिया गया है. सो एज ऑफ सितंबर 2022, अगर सितंबर की हम बात करें, देन देयर वाज अ डिक्लाइन इन द फॉरेक्स रिजर्व्स. ये आप सबको भी पता होगा, यू मस्ट बी रीडिंग द न्यूज़पेपर्स, जहां पे इन ऑर्डर टू सपोर्ट द रूपी, द गवर्नर ऑफ RBI has been trying to intervene massively into the forex market, and thereby there has been a decline in our reserves. तो हमारा रिजर्व्स डिक्रीज हुआ है, एंड इट हैज बीन सेटल्ड एट नाउ एट $537.5 billion, अ डिक्लाइन. एंड द मेजर रीजन फॉर द डिक्लाइन आर टू reasons. फर्स्ट इज द revaluation लॉसेस. तो जब भी देर इज एन एप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द यूएस डॉलर, आर रुपी गेट्स डेप्रिशिएटेड. बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आर फॉरेक्स रिजर्व्स हैज डिक्लाइन, बिकॉज वी नीड टू सपोर्ट द रुपी. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट देर इज अनादर रीजन. द अनादर रीजन इज दैट increasing yield of the bonds in US. So US ki jo bonds hain, because they are increasing their interest rate there, and since US ki jo currency hai, that is dollar, is a safe haven asset, people has been transferring money from the emerging markets like India and settling down in US, whereby they are earning a higher interest rates on the bonds. So because of increasing yields on the US bonds and the appreciation of the US dollar, we have seen a decline in the forex reserves of India. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's move forward and talk about the major changes. So based on the macroeconomic activity and outlook, what are the major changes or the decision taken by the monetary policy committee? First and foremost, in the policy rate, that is the repo rate. Repo rate, aap sabko pata hi hoga. We have already talked about it. What is repo rate? It is the rate at which RBI lends to the commercial banks. It is a way through RBI injects liquidity into the market through the commercial banks. ठीक है? अब repo rate earlier it was 5.4%. Last जब meeting held हुई थी it was 5.4%. Now it has been increased by 50 basis point. 1 basis point is 0.01, 50 basis point is 0.5. So 5.4 से 5.9% हो गया है. So what is the current policy rate applicable in India? It is 5.9%. Now, क्या हो सकता है इसका impact? Now, because of increasing policy rate, अब जो loans होंगे, they are going to be more cheaper or expensive. It is going to be more expensive. Since repo rate increase कर दिया गया है, loans will be more expensive. As well as deposits के ऊपर भी rates high होंगे. So you'll be getting a higher rate on the deposits if you are making deposits into the bank. And at the same time, if you are taking any kind of loan or credit, then you will have to pay a higher rate. So आपके EMIs महंगे होने वाले हैं because of the increase in the policy repo rate. Similarly, इन सब rates में भी changes आएंगे. हमारा जो SDF है, standing deposit facility. You all know SDF is the tool which tries to absorb liquidity from the market. And it is done without any collateral. यहाँ पे collateral नहीं होता. ठीक है? तो SDF भी हमारा 5.15 था. ये भी 50 basis points से increase होगा to 5.65%. Now, you should know and understand that there is a difference between the policy rate and the SDF. इन दोनों के बीच में जो difference है, that is of 25 basis point. 0.25% का difference है. So always if you see the difference between SDF and policy rate, it is going to be 0.25. अगर आप policy rate से MSF को देखोगे, तो ये आपका कुछ, ये भी 0.25 से ही difference होगा इन दोनों के बीच में. Now these three elements are the part of the liquidity corridor. So जो हमारा liquidity adjustment facility है, what is this liquidity adjustment facility? It is the facility provided by RBI in the overnight market or for term repos and reverse repos, whereby you can either increase or decrease the liquidity in the market. उसको बोला जाता है liquidity adjustment facility. And what is the corridor? So the corridor has SDF, ठीक है? Then we have the MSF, marginal standing facility. अगर ये absorption tool है, then this is injection tool. It injects liquidity into the market. तो इसीलिए आप देखोगे ये rate हमेशा higher होगा, right? So this rate will be higher. तो 6.15 यहाँ पे है, SDF is 5.65. A difference of 50 basis point. तो liquidity corridor कितना बड़ा है? It is 50 basis point का हमारा liquidity corridor है. I hope आपको समझ आ रहा होगा. If you see the difference, 5.65 और 6.15 का जो difference है, इसके बीच में आएगा हमारा repo rate, which is at 5.9. यहाँ का difference 0.25, यहाँ का difference 0.25. I hope this is clear to you. एक second लो और इनको पूरा को देखो, ठीक है? So policy repo rate has been increased by 50 basis point to 5.9%. Similarly, SDF, MSF, bank rate and fixed reverse repo rate has also been increased. Apart from this, fixed reverse repo rate, since it is not linked to the liquidity adjustment facility, 3.35 पे ही maintained है. But apart from that, all other rates has been increased by 50 basis point. And if you talk about the difference between the policy repo rate and SDF, it is 0.25. The difference between policy repo rate and MSF is 0.25 because of the liquidity corridor whereby the repo rate is in between and one would be lower and one would be higher. I hope this is clear to you. बहुत अच्छे से समझ आ गया होगा. Now let's move forward and talk about the other major decisions that has been taken by the Monetary Policy Committee. So, what is the stance? Liquidity ka hame samaj aa gaya. They felt that there is more of inflation into the country. So, the repo rate should be increased in order to absorb the liquidity from the market. Agar repo rate zyada hoga, log kam loan lenge and the liquidity in the market would be absorbed. Similarly, अगर liquidity आप absorb कर लोगे, तो जो हमारा इन्फ्लेशन है दैट विल ऑल्सो कम डाउन. सो वॉट इज द स्टैंड दैट दे हैव टेकन. We have already talked about the various stances that RBI can take. It can be accommodative, hawkish, neutral or the calibrated tightening. Now during the COVID-19 pandemic, जब बहुत ज़्यादा pandemic था, जो हमारा demand था, demand slow down हो गया था, and because of that, the RBI and the governor of the RBI had to come up with the stance of accommodation. But since inflation has been eating up our economy and the economic activity, now the stance of the MPC has been to remain focused on withdrawal of accommodation, that is calibrated tightening. So what is the stance taken by RBI? It is calibrated tightening, as we have seen in the last monetary policy meeting as well. I hope ये आपको समझ आ गया होगा. Why have they taken withdrawal of accommodation as it stands? In order to ensure that inflation remains within the target of 4% with a band of plus minus 2%. I hope this is clear to you, and these decisions are taken in consonance with the RBI's objective of maintaining the price stability as well as supporting the growth. अब इनके डिफरेंसेस क्या हैं? व्हाट इज हॉकिश, व्हाट इज अकोमोडेटिव, न्यूट्रल एंड कैलिब्रेटेड टाइटनिंग, यू आर गोइंग टू राइट इट डाउन इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. ये ऑलरेडी भी हमने डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. आपको बस इसका बहुत छोटे में कहाँ पे इंटरेस्ट रेट इंक्रीज होगा, कहाँ इंटरेस्ट रेट डिक्रीज होगा, वो आपको बताना है. नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड टॉक अबाउट द रैशनल. तो जब भी मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी स्टेटमेंट आती है, वो अपने डिसीजंस देते हैं कि पॉलिसी रेपो रेट कितनी होनी चाहिए, प्रोजेक्शंस क्या हैं उनके. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दे आल्सो गिव द रैशनल व्हाई दे हैव टेकन सच डिसीजन. एंड एवरी मेंबर ऑफ द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमेटी हैज आल्सो टू गिव अ डिटेल्ड रिटन स्टेटमेंट व्हाई दे हैव गिवन अ यस और अ नो in regard to the decision that has been taken by the monetary policy committee. So if we talk about the rationale, so they have talked about the global economy, the domestic economy, what are the growth factors and inflation, the financial market conditions. Apart from that, the liquidity as well as the forex reserves, in sub factors ko discuss karke hi ye rate decide kiya jata hai. Now talking about the global economy, so the governor of RBI and other members of RBI felt that the global economic outlook is very bleak. It's the economic activity has been very weakened, and the major reason was because of first the pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, followed by the protracted conflict in Ukraine. यूक्रेन रशिया के वॉर के वजह से हमारा जो ग्लोबल आउटलुक है बहुत ही वीक है. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट द गवर्नर आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट अ थर्ड मेजर शॉक. व्हाट इज अ थर्ड मेजर शॉक फॉर द इमर्जिंग इकोनॉमीज ऑफ इंडिया? द थर्ड मेजर शॉक इज द एग्रेसिव मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी एक्शंस एंड स्टांसेस टेकन बाय द डेवलप्ड नेशंस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. तो व्हाट इज दिस एग्रेसिव मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी एक्शन? So since inflation is being seen by all the countries and majorly by the developed countries as well, developed countries such as the US, the UK, and since inflation is high in those countries, their central bank has been trying to be very aggressive with their monetary policy and the stances, and they have been going on to increase their interest rate. Now, if they increase the interest rate, this is bad for the Indian economy, because the FPI that we are receiving because of the interest rate differential will get lower down, and people will start taking out money from India and investing in US for two reasons. First, increasing interest rates that they are getting in their own home country, and secondly, because of the nature of the US currency, that is dollar. Dollar is more stronger and stable as compared to the Indian rupee. Iske wajah se paise India se bahar jaane lagenge, and this entire concept is known as capital flight. कैपिटल फ्लाइट बोला जाता है इस कंसेप्ट को. तो कभी भी आप न्यूज़पेपर में रीड करो, व्हाट इज कैपिटल फ्लाइट? व्हेन ह्यूज एक्सोडस ऑफ मनी, व्हेन मोर पीपल टुगेदर ट्राई टू टेक आउट मनी फ्रॉम एन इमर्जिंग इकोनॉमी, एंड दे टेक आउट बिकॉज they are getting more better returns in their own home country, then that concept is known as capital flight. I hope this is clear to you. Capital flight can also happen because if the foreign portfolio investors or the foreign investors do not believe in the domestic economic activity, agar unko jo India ki economy hai us pe bharosa hi nahi hai, then at that time also they will take out the money. Agar bahut unstable hai hamara economy, at that time also people can take out their money and that can result in capital flight. What is capital flight? Huge exodus of money going out of a country. So ये global economic outlook है and because of this weakening of the global economic activity, we are seeing experiencing a lots of volatility into the market. बहुत सारे sell off देखने को मिले हैं, बहुत सारा capital flight देखने को मिला है. Bond yields, bond markets, US के वो increase हुए हैं and therefore we have also seen a strengthening of the US dollar to a 20 year high. तो उनकी जो करेंसी है वो और ज्यादा स्ट्रांग हो गई है. नाउ इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द इमर्जिंग मार्केट इकोनॉमीज, व्हाट आर द चैलेंजेस दैट दीज स्मॉल इमर्जिंग मार्केट इकोनॉमीज आर फेसिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द स्ट्रेंथनिंग ऑफ द यूएस डॉलर एंड सेल ऑफ इन इक्विटी. द मेन चैलेंज दैट दे आर फेसिंग, द प्रेशर दैट दे आर फेसिंग इज द रिट्रेंचमेंट ऑफ देयर पोर्टफोलियो फ्लोस. आपने भी देखा होगा जब जून जुलाई के टाइम पे वी हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ मनी फ्लोइंग आउट ऑफ इंडिया. जो हमारा पोर्टफोलियो फ्लोस थे, द फॉरेन पोर्टफोलियो इन्वेस्टर, दे हैव टेकन आउट मनी फ्रॉम इंडिया. सो दिस इज अ रीजन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, द इमर्जिंग इकोनॉमी आर ऑल्सो सीइंग अ डेप्रिसिएशन इन द करेंसी, हर्टिंग them because they import a lot. Reserve losses, the forex reserve that they are having, that they have, there is a loss in that, and the financial stability risk that they are facing. ठीक है, now these are general statements, आप सबको पता होगा, but you should know what all have been talked about in the monetary policy statement. Second, talking about the domestic economy. So domestic economy, बहुत सारे factors हैं. The first is growth. So RBI governor and the other members have said that the Indian economy has been resilient and they have been performing well. How are they stating this statement? First and foremost, they talk about the real GDP. उन्होंने कहा कि जो हमारी real GDP है, that has been more than the pre-pandemic level. Pre-pandemic level से ज़्यादा है, and now it has been around 13.5%, which is a very good growth. Apart from that, if you talk about the supply side में भी हमें growth देखने को मिली है, which is around 12.7%. Around 13% की growth supply side पे भी है. We have also seen the resiliences of the agricultural sector. Agriculture has been performing well. And we have also seen supply conditions to be improving. ठीक है, उसके अलावा if we talk about on the demand side, then we have seen an increase in the urban consumption. Urban consumption has been revived. One of the major reason could be the festival season. Festival के वजह से दो सालों से pandemic ही था, अब लोग खर्च कर रहे हैं, right? So we have seen an increase in the urban consumption because of the festival season, a gradual improvement in the rural demand as well. The rural demand में भी हमें improvement देखने को मिली है, though it is a gradual one. And apart from that, if we talk about the investment demand, that has also been increasing and services has also been increasing. So taking all these factors into consideration, the committee has made certain projection. So the growth projection for quarter one of 2023-24 next year has been at 7.2%. अभी के लिए मैंने बता ही दिया 7% इन्होंने consider किया है, that for the year 2022-23 दो quarters बचे हैं, the growth will be at 7%. ठीक है, now let's move forward and talk about the next very factor, that is inflation. Inflation ke bare mein unhone ye bataya hai that major inflation, the main reason behind inflation this time is because of increase in prices of foods and vegetable. So cereals, vegetables, pulses, spices, milk, in sab mein bahut zyada inflation dekhne ko mili hai. However, if you talk about the prices of fuel, the fuel inflation has gradually decline. तो अभी जो inflation है, which is around 7%, CPI based inflation जो आया था, data for the month of August, it was 7%, and we have seen a decline in fuel inflation, however an increase in the food inflation. The volatility अभी food में देखी जा रही है, एंड बेस्ड ऑन दिस इन्फ्लेशन प्रोजेक्शन 6.7% पे ही रिटेन की गई है. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इन्फ्लेशन प्रोजेक्शन फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर क्वार्टर वन ऑफ नेक्स्ट ईयर इट इज 5%. Now, therefore, the committee is saying that by the first quarter of the next year, we will be within the target of 4 ± 2%. I hope this is clear to you. Now, let's move forward and talk about the third important condition, that is liquidity and the financial market conditions. So, यहाँ पे RBI के MPC के जो members हैं और RBI के जो governor हैं उन्होंने ये बताया that our system, the liquidity in the system overall is in surplus. However, if we look clearly, then our bank credit, the bank credit has increased by 16.2%, which is very good for the economy. तो अभी boost देखने को मिल रहा है, investment demand increase हो रहे हैं and therefore bank credit has been increasing by 16.2%. Thereby meaning that people are taking loan. अगर लोग loan ले रहे हैं and if they are investing such loans, then this is going to revive our economy. But if we talk about the deposit rates, so deposits of the commercial banks has also been increasing, but it is lower than that of the bank credit. It is around 9.5%. I hope this is clear to you. Next is the US dollar appreciation depreciation. तो इन्होंने ये बताया है that the US dollar has been appreciating against a basket of currency. तो what is the rate at which it is appreciating? It is appreciating at the rate of 14.5% against a basket of currencies of the major emerging economies. But if we talk about Indian rupee, our Indian rupee, अगर ये appreciate कर रहा है तो बाकी के currency depreciate कर रहे होंगे. If we talk about specifically of Indian rupee, then our Indian rupee has been depreciating by 7.4%, which is very less than the average of the other country's currency being depreciated. Therefore, it says that our currency has been doing or performing much better than its counterparts as well as several reserve currencies of the world. I hope this is clear to you. So these are basically the rationale. Kis basis pe humne policy repo rate ko decide kiya hai. Next is the external sector. External sector mein first and foremost we have talked about the current account deficit. Current account deficit aap sabko pata hai. Our एक्सपोर्ट्स ले लो, इम्पोर्ट्स ले लो, प्राइमरी इनकम, सेकेंडरी इनकम सबको मिला के हमारा जो करंट अकाउंट डेफिशिट है इट इज वेल विद इन द टारगेट. सो वी यूजुअली हैव अ साइकोलॉजिकल लेवल. ऐसे कुछ रिटर्न नहीं है कि 3% होने चाहिए, 4% होना चाहिए, बट साइकोलॉजिकली और बेस्ड ऑन कस्टम्स वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट आर current account deficit should be within 3%. तो अभी का जो current account deficit है for the quarter one of 2023 has been at 2.8%, which is good enough. इतना ज़्यादा नहीं है. But if we talk about trade deficit में क्या आ जाएगा? Export and imports of goods only. The trade deficit हमारा high है. It is at 8.1%. That means we are importing much more than what we are exporting. ठीक है? Now if we talk about services, what was the growth in the exports of services? Services की जो export है, we have seen a robust growth of 35.4% year on year basis. So last year ke comparison mein the growth in the services sector is enormous. Apart from that, if you talk about remittances is also increased for India, which is around 22.6%. So one of the major way of getting forex through the current account, so current account ke components se aap dekhoge to it is the remittances which has been bringing more of forex reserves to the current account. Theek hai? And we do not have a liability against it. The current account capital account ka difference ye hi hota hai ki current account mein koi liability attached nahi hoti. People are earning there and they are sending remittances to India. We need not pay them back. If we talk about on the capital account part mein basically FDI or FPI aati hai. We have seen an improvement in both of देन. ठीक है, नंबर्स इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, बस आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि इंप्रूवमेंट है या नहीं. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. नाउ व्हेन इज द नेक्स्ट मीटिंग गोइंग टू बी हेल्ड? सो द नेक्स्ट मीटिंग विल बी हैपनिंग इन दिसंबर फ्रॉम 5th to 7th 2022, और तब देखते हैं क्या पॉलिसी रेट्स आती है और वेदर द लिक्विडिटी इन द मार्केट इज स्टिल बींग एब्जॉर्ब्ड और वट policy and stances will the monetary policy committee take up then? Now, members of MPC, this is important. ये थोड़ा सा मैंने आपको समझाने की कोशिश की है. So, as we have talked about under section 45ZB of the RBI Act, there are six members. First and foremost, the chairman. The chairman would be RBI governor. Ex officio हमेशा कोई भी यहाँ पे नाम हो. As of now, it is Sri Shaktikanta Das. अगर इनकी जगह कोई और भी आता है, at that time also, the chairperson would be the RBI governor. Apart from that, we are going to have the deputy governor of RBI as an ex officio member. And third, a member from RBI that will be nominated by the central board of RBI. The central board jo hogi RBI ki, wo ek member ko nominate karega. And that member will also be a part of MPC. To MPC mein 6 members hai. Aise samjho, 3 members RBI ke hote hai. 3 members हमारे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट द्वारा नॉमिनेट किए जाते हैं. तो 3 members RBI के कौन कौन? First is the ex officio chairman, ex officio deputy governor, and third a member of RBI nominated by the board of RBI. Simple. Now the rest 3 members, these are appointed by the central government. The central government appoint करती है and they are appointed for a tenure of 4 years or any other term whichever is earlier. अगर 4 साल के लिए अपॉइंट किए गए हैं एंड इफ दे आर वर्किंग और इफ द गवर्नर सेज और इफ द गवर्नमेंट सेज कि ये 5 साल तक काम करेंगे, देयर टेन्योर वुड बी 4 इयर्स ओनली whichever is earlier. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. नाउ टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज दैट यू शुड नो और फैक्ट्स अबाउट द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमिटी इज The Monetary Policy Committee should meet at least 4 times a year. एक साल में 4 बार उनको मिलना ही पड़ेगा. Now you must be wondering कि bi-monthly monetary policy statements release होते हैं. That means 6 times a year वो मिल सकते हैं. But अगर कई बार ऐसे situation हो जहाँ पे MPC मिलना ना चाहे, then it can do so. However, throughout the year उनको at least 4 बार मिलना पड़ेगा. So for at least 4 times they will have to sit and discuss the happenings in the economy. And talking about the quorum, what is the quorum? So a minimum number of member is required whenever a meeting is held of MPC. That minimum number of member that is required would be 4. 6 member mein se at least 4 members present hone chahiye in order to conduct the meeting of Monetary Policy Committee. I hope this is clear to you, crystal clear to you. Now there are questions for you to be solved and write it down in the comment section. Kuch bachche hi likhte hain, sare nahi likhte. It is just for you, for your benefit. Agar kuch samajh nahi aata, you can always ask. Whatever we discuss, based on that only these questions are being framed. So the first question says we need to identify the incorrect statements. The first statement says the central government determines the inflation target based on CPI once in 5 years and publishes or notifies in the official gazette. The second says section 45ZA. Now you need to be clear. Kya bas government hi karta hai ya kisi ki consultation leta hai? I'm giving you the hint as well. Second says section 45ZA. It is section 45ZA or 45ZB that talks about the constitution of MPC and the number of members. The third statement says the RBI Act was amended to provide a statutory basis for the implementation of flexible inflation target framework. You need to identify the incorrect statements and write it down in the comment section. The second question says in the recent September 2022 meet of the Monetary Policy Committee, by what basis point has the policy rate been increased or decreased? Very simple question. Let's move forward to the next question, which says, with reference to the Indian economy, consider the following question. Now, this question has been there in one of the exam, one of the government exams. वहाँ पे ये question आया हुआ है 2 marks के. So अच्छे से पढ़ो and then you try to answer it. The question says, which of the above are the components of the monetary policy? Monetary policy जो हमने discuss किया उसके components क्या क्या हो सकते हैं? We have bank rate, open market operations, public debt, public revenue. Very simple. थोड़ा सा दिमाग लगाओगे answer आ जाएगा इसका. Moving forward to the next question, the question says, according to the RBI governor, which of the following is the third major shock in that the Indian economy is facing? हमने डिस्कस किया, फर्स्ट वाज द कोविड 19 पेंडेमिक, सेकंड वाज द रशिया यूक्रेन वॉर, एंड व्हाट इज द थर्ड मेजर शॉक दैट द इंडियन इकोनॉमी इज फेसिंग, यू नीड टू आंसर इट डाउन. वेरी सिंपल अगेन. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन व्हिच सेज, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट रिगार्डिंग द एमपीसी. First, it decides the RBI's benchmark interest rate. Second, it functions under the chairmanship of Union Finance Minister. मैंने चेयरपर्सन की बात ऑलरेडी की है आपके साथ. It should meet at least 6 times a year. Again, इस पे ध्यान देना. And the quorum required for the meeting of MPC is 3 members. अगर किसी को नहीं पता होगा वो इसको करेक्ट मार्क करके आएगा. But now you all know what should be the quorum of the MPC. Simple, the answer has been shared with you. This was all that I intended to share with you in today's session regarding the statement on development and regulatory policies. Uske liye hum alag ek video lekar aayenge. This was all for today. I hope you enjoyed the session. In case of any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment section. Till then, take care and bye-bye.